In types of catalysis, already we have discussed homogeneous catalysis and heterogeneous catalysis. See the third one, autocatalysis. What is that? Autocatalysis. What is homogeneous catalysis? If the catalyst used and the reactants are in the same phase, that is homogeneous. Heterogeneous catalysis means if the catalyst and the reactants are not in the same phase, that is heterogeneous catalysis. Their mechanism also I had explained. In this class, let's see about autocatalysis. What is this? If one of here no substance is added externally as catalyst, generally in a reaction, catalyst is added externally to the reaction mixture. Catalyst is added externally to the reaction mixture. But in this reaction, no substance is added externally. One of the products formed in the reaction acts as catalyst. Such a catalyst is called autocatalyst, and that process is called autocatalysis. So the process, it is the process in which one of the products formed itself acts as a catalyst. Autocatalysis is the process in which one of the products formed itself acts as a catalyst. Okay, so that process is called autocatalysis, and that substance which acts as catalyst is called autocatalyst. Let's see some examples for autocatalysis. If you take a decomposition of arsenic hydride AsH3, this arsenic hydride decomposes to arsenic plus hydrogen gas. This is gas, solid gas. In this reaction is initially slow reaction, decomposition of arsine. This is called arsine. Decomposition of arsine is initially slow, but after some time the reaction is accelerated. That means rate of reaction increases. Why? Because of this arsenic formed, it acts as a catalyst. Reaction is accelerated. So in this reaction, arsenic is the autocatalyst. So arsenic is autocatalyst. See one more example. Reaction between KMnO4 aqua plus oxalic acid H2C2O4. H2C2O4 is called what? Oxalic acid. Let it 5 moles. Similarly, 3H2SO4 aqua gives rise to oxalic acid KMnO4 acidic medium. In acidic medium, KMnO4 here acts as an oxidizing agent, whereas oxalic acid, this is oxalic acid, okay? Oxalic acid acts as reductant. In this, what are the products? See, K2SO4 aqua plus 2MnSO4 aqua plus, what are the other products? 10CO2 gas plus water, 8 moles of water liquid. Okay, this is the balanced equation. It is a redox reaction in acidic medium. Here KMnO4 acts as oxidant, whereas oxalic acid acts as, what is that? Reductant. In this, this reaction is also initially slow, but after some time it is accelerated due to the formation of manganese ion. So in this reaction, what is the autocatalyst? Mn plus 2. That means MnSO4 acts as autocatalyst. In MnSO4, there is manganese ion, Mn plus 2, that acts as autocatalyst. See, one more example. That is ester hydrolysis. CH3COOCH5. Generally, hydrolysis of ester is carried out in the presence of an acid or base. So, acid or base may act as a catalyst externally. But we can carry out without the catalyst also. That means without the addition of any external substance also, we can carry out the hydrolysis. See how does the reaction take place. Here also H2O liquid gives rise to CH3COOH aqua plus C2H5OH aqua. These are the products. In this reaction is initially slow, but in the progress of the reaction, it is accelerated due to the formation of acetic acid. That means here acetic acid acts as autocatalyst. Here acetic acid acts as autocatalyst. So what is autocatalysis? The process in which one of the products formed itself acts as a catalyst is called autocatalysis, and the substance or product which acts as catalyst is said to be autocatalyst. These are some examples for autocatalysis. Autocatalysis. Next, go for another catalysis, that is induced catalysis. Fourth one, induced catalysis. What is this? You know, some reactions may not take place itself, but in combination with some other reactions, they also take place. So such reactions or such catalysis reactions, which itself doesn't occur, but in combination with other reactions starts to occur, is called induced catalysis. What is induced catalysis? A reaction itself does not occur, but in the combination of other reaction it starts to occur. That is called induced catalysis. So in induced catalysis, a reaction itself does not occur, but starts to occur in combination with another reaction. So by another reaction, this slow or non-feasible reaction also start to react. This type of catalysis reaction. So one reaction catalyzes the other one. One reaction is initially does not occur, but after mixing with another reaction, it also starts to react. Here, one reaction is catalyzed by another reaction. So what is the example for this one? See, sodium arsenite, Na3AsO3. When it is kept in air, it is not oxidized. But you know, Na2SO3, what is this? sodium sulfide. Sodium sulfide combines with oxygen to give sodium sulfate. Na2 sodium sulfide, sodium sulfate. Sodium arsenite, Na3SO3 means sodium arsenite. Sodium arsenite. It is not oxidized in air. It is non-feasible reaction. But when we take mixture of both, that means sodium arsenite and sodium sulfide, if both are placed in the same vessel, what happens is it also starts to react with the oxygen in the air to form sodium arsenate. Sodium arsenate. Generally, the first reaction itself does not occur. But by seeing the second reaction, because of a second reaction, first reaction also occurs. So this type of feasibility of a non-feasible reaction by another reaction is called what? Induced catalysis. Have you got the meaning of induced catalysis? Initially, a reaction does not occur, but with the presence of another reaction, that also occurs. That is the meaning of induced catalysis. Next, another catalysis. Let us go to another catalysis, that is shape selective catalysis.